No, you were doing your show.
Yeah.
And my mom was very thrilled. That made her entire trip. She was in California for about 10 days.
I do remember that.
And it scared me silly.
Yeah.
It really did. But it was very nice of you to do that.
Sure.
Now, we're talking about the contract and so on and so forth. You just signed a new deal here at NBC. Have you ever, how many years has it been? You're working on your 23rd year?
Yeah, we finished 23 in September, and I understand if you do 25, you get a Timex watch from NBC. may go for the watch.
Going for the watch.
Go for the watch.
Have you, in all of that time, has there ever been anything NBC said, nope, we're not going to give it to you?
I've pretty well got a lock on them. No. You've negotiated with them. No, we've been very fortunate.
Oh, no, I think my negotiations and your negotiations are two different floors of the building.
No, we've had a good run with the show. We've been very lucky. The audience has been very loyal.
Yeah.
It's been a nice ride.
Yeah, but I do think you,
by the way,
pretty much whatever you want.
You've been doing this now for what, 3 years?
Yeah, 3 years and a couple of months.
I tell you what, you will find if you continue this, there will come a time when you run out of questions. Maybe that's happened to you already.
Could be happening now.
Right now. I sense that. You will have the starlet on, and you will have asked her whether her mother or father had the greatest influence and whether she likes to live in California or not. I have about run out of questions.
Yeah.
I have about six or seven left that I have never, ever asked on the show. I brought them along.
Oh, good. Thank God.
Just in case you run into that bad interview.
Thank
where
God.
You just don't know what to. I'm going to will these to you.
Maybe I'll jot these down.
All right. You're in real trouble. You say to your guest, what would you do if I jammed a lit highway flare up your nose? You see? It's just one there. Now, you had Bo Derek on the other night, right?
Yes, we did.
You could have said to her, have you ever used one of your vital organs as a hand puppet?
All right. Hand puppet, highway flare.
Some of these obviously are going to be better than others.
Yeah, well, you got to try them. Or you skipped one.
Here's one. Where do you suppose the sock goes that disappears in the dryer?
Yeah, that's good. Thought-provoking. Uh-huh.
You didn't pay for that plastic surgery, did you? And my favorite, and I think it will probably be yours, but we'll be the judge of that
all
moment.
Right.
You say to your guest, how would American history have been changed if the Secretary of Agriculture in the Roosevelt administration had been Johnny Mathis?
Okay. I think, Johnny, I'll stay with the highway flare and the hand puppet.
That highway flare and the hand puppet.
I like those pretty well. Oh, my gosh. You get a lot of movie offers living in California all these years? People are always saying, this man would be perfect. He would be like another Cary Grant sort of person.
You know, I used to get some offers, and Jack Lemmon always used to say, you know, I could have played a lot of things.
Exactly.
That Jack played, which
would
have been fun. But with the Tonight Show, as you know, when you're on the schedule, I only have, like, the longest period during the whole year is 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
You really don't have time to make a picture.
Yeah.
And as you get older, all of a sudden, it doesn't become much fun. This is fun because this is what television is. You come out, it's right now, it's spontaneous, and you give and you take, and some nights you're good, some nights you don't know what's going to happen. Movies I find kind of boring. You sit there and you have to do it over and over and over again.
You wait 8 hours to do one line.
It takes a lot of discipline.
Yeah.
So I did do Looking for Love with Connie Francis.
1965 offering, I believe.
1965, mm-hmm.
And what was the film, what was the plot in Looking for Love, other than obviously Looking for Love?
I remember the ad was, could Connie pass the kiss test? It was an exciting picture. And it's the only movie that I know that the Motion Picture Academy transferred to flammable nitrate stock. I think it is. Usually they do it the other way around, but this one they transferred it back, and it was a, look, they gave me some money, and I was one day, and I went in and did it, and played myself, so it was no big deal.
How do you like the neighborhood? We're neighbors.
Well, I called you about a week ago to come play tennis, and you called, and you didn't show.
I know.
Why not?
Well, I had cold feet. You know what I mean? I'd feel like a jerk playing tennis with you.
Why?
Well, because 90% of the day, I feel like a jerk.
Nobody explained it to me that way. We're out in Malibu.
Yeah, sure. And you're having some work done on the place? We see
fixing up a few things.
Yeah, we sit there late at night in the car.
Yeah. Well, let's keep it that way.
Yeah. Oh my God, you got to go do your show here. Huh?
Yeah. I've got to. As a matter of fact, what I'm doing tonight, I could do the finish here. I told the first part of the joke on my show earlier tonight.
Yeah.
And I was going to do the punchline here, so people who watch my show will tune in
and
see this
show. An experiment in television.
This is a joke.
All right.
In other words, you will not hear...
This is good.
This is the punchline to the joke that I did earlier on my show.
Okay, all right.
And the man says to Mrs. O'Hara, "I'm not so sure about that. He got out three times to go to the bathroom." Now, that's the punchline to the joke that I did. So
people are in on a little television history tonight.
That's right.
Yeah.
Unfortunate as it is, they are.
Yeah. All right, now, well, let me see what we're doing here. We got to the station identification. What are we? That's it?
I think that means say goodbye.
Say goodbye.
He's doing one of these.
All right, we're done. Okay. It was a pleasure. And what do you think? It wasn't too awkward, was it?
I had fun.
Oh, good. I'm glad you did. You were terrific.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks for everything, Johnny. Nice to see you. Johnny Carson, folks. Thank you very much. Very funny.